स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू आवर यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ दिल्ली पब्लिक स्कूल बानू शाह परबेतिया। टुडे आई एम दिव्या स्टैंडिंग हियर टू टीच यू द फर्स्ट चैप्टर ऑफ क्लास 3 साइंस। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल कवर द टॉपिक्स हर्बीवोरस, कार्निवोरस, ओमनीवोरस, पेट एनिमल्स, डोमेस्टिक एनिमल्स, हाउ एनिमल्स ईट एंड फूड चेन। So first of all, I am going to give you the definition of herbivores. What are herbivores? Plants eating animals are called herbivores. The animals which eat plants, only plants, they doesn't prefer fleshes of any other animals or any non-veg particles. They only depend on plant is known as herbivores. Example, cow, goat. Second one is carnivores. What is carnivores? Flesh eating animals are called carnivores. The animals which only prefer fleshes of other animals is known as carnivores. Example, tiger, lion. What do you mean by omnivores? Some animals eat both plant as well as flesh. You have heard some animals which eat both plants as well as fleshes of other animals. These animals are known as omnivores. For example, crow and human. We are human and we prefer both plants also as vegetable and fleshes also as meat, fish or egg. These all are non-veg particles or fleshes of other animals. Now, another topic is pet animals. What do you mean by pet animals? Do you have any pet animals in your home? So, what are pet animals? Animals live with us are called pet animals. Those animals who lives with us in our home, they always give us company. They are their best friends. They like dogs and dogs guard our home. Next, cat. Cat also live with us. Rabbit. Rabbit also live with us. You all play with your pets animals. These animals are known as pet animals. Next is domestic animal. What do you mean by domestic animal? The animals which helps us in many ways are called domestic animals. The animals which live with us and they always help us in many ways, like horse, donkey. They help us to carry loads and luggage. Dog or donkey हमें सामान ढोने में help करता है. देखे होंगे donkey एक जगह से दूसरा जगह सामान लेके जाता है. So horse and donkeys help us to carry loads. Now our next one is cow, buffaloes and goats. Cows, buffaloes and goats help us by giving milk. And sheep help us. Sheep gives us wool. Hen and duck. We eat the fleshes of hen and ducks. So these are the examples of domestic animals. Now I am going to teach you our next topic, how animals eat. So there are 5 ways how animals take their food. First of all, I will teach you 3, then I will give you another 2. First is gnawers. Here G is silent, so the pronunciation is gnawers. The animals gnaws their food are called gnawers. Example, squirrel, rabbit, rat. They have very sharp front teeth for cutting. Gnawers means, have you ever seen squirrel? They take their food inside the mouth and they only cut it and eat it. So the animals gnaws their food are called gnawers. They have very sharp teeth. They have 2 front teeth, very sharp. With the help of the front teeth, they cut their food Now, second is animals that swallow their food whole. Second, eating process is animal that swallow their food whole. Some animals like lizard. Have you ever seen lizard in your home? They always use their tongue to eat the insects, and their sticky tongues catch the insect and swallow it. They didn't chew it. So, example of this type of eating process is frogs, chameleons, lizards, snakes. But here is a difference between lizard and snake. Snake doesn't have sticky tongue, and lizard and frogs have sticky tongues. Snake catch their food and they swallow it. Snake doesn't have teeth, so it cannot chew the food. They have long and sticky tongue. I have told you frog and lizard, chameleon have long and sticky tongues. Now, third one is animal that tear and chew fleshes. Some animals are those animals who use their both teeth, front also and backward also, and they use to tear the fleshes of other animals and then they chew it, then they take it inside. Now, example of this type of process of eating is lion, tiger and wolves. Have you seen lion in zoo? They have two sharp front teeth and their back teeth are always flat and broad. With the help of front teeth, they tear the fleshes, and with the help of broad and flat teeth, they chew the food. Their front teeth are sharp, curved and pointed. The front teeth of lion, tiger, wolves are pointed, curved and sharp, which help them to tear the fleshes of other animals. Now, the second point is their back teeth are flat and broad. The back teeth of these animals are flat and broad. Chauda hota hai aur flat hota hai. जो कि चबाने में हेल्प करता है. Now, our next one is animals that eat and chew grass. Some animals eat grasses and chew them. Example, goat, cow, buffaloes. These are also known as domestic animals. So, domestic animals chew only grasses. They have flat, sharp and broad front teeth. Have you ever seen the teeth of cow, buffaloes or goats? They have a flat and broad teeth, front also and backward also. Now, second point is these animals are also called curved chewing animals. Why these animals are called curved chewing animals? Have you any idea? No. These animals are also called curved chewing animals because they swallow their food inside their body. And animals like cows and buffaloes and goats first swallow their food inside, and after some times they bring it back to the mouth, then they chew it very well for an hour. Then they take out the ruminant from those food items, then they digest it or then they eat it. Firstly, they store all the grasses in their stomach, then they take it to the mouth, then they chew it. So, that's why these animals are called curd chewing animals. Now, third point is, they swallow their food first. As I told you, these animals swallow their food first. Then after, bring it to the mouth and chew the ruminant. Then after, they bring it to the mouth and then they chew the ruminant of the grasses. Now our fifth part is animals that take in liquid food. Some animals or insects are those who only take the liquid food. For example, mosquitoes, leech, butterflies. Look at this point. These animals have a long, thin, hollow tube that they use to suck the food into their mouth. These animals, like mosquito, leech, and butterflies, have a long, thin, hollow tube. Like straw, we use straw for drinking juice or sucking juice. They have a hollow, thin, and long tube they use to suck the food inside their mouth. And with the help of this long, thin, and hollow tube, they use to suck the food inside their body. Second point is, butterflies and bees use this tube to suck the nectar from the flowers. Butterfly and bees use these tubes to suck the nectar. Sweet juice of flower is known as nectar, used to suck the nectar from the flower. Now, mosquitoes and leech. Do you know what is leech? Mosquitoes and leech suck the blood, and just like mosquito suck the blood from our body, leech also stick to our body and it also suck the blood from our body. Mosquitoes and leech suck the blood of our body by this process. Animals that take in liquid by food. By this process, mosquito and leech also suck the blood. Now, third is cat and dogs lap up milk and water with their tongue. This process is also called lapping. Now, what is lapping? Cats, have you ever seen cats or dogs drinking milk or water? They always use their tongue to drink milk and water. So, the process by which cats and dogs drink the water or milk by the use of tongue is, this process is known as lapping. Now, our next topic is food chain. A deer eats grass. Do you know deer? They only eat grass because deer is a herbivore animal. A deer eat grass and a lion eat deer. And deer and the lion is a carnivore animal. So, lion eat deers. Deer eat grass and lion eats deer. This chain is called food chain. This chain, deer eating grass and lion eating deer. This chain is known as food chain. Example, this one is grain, a form of plant. Rat eats grain. Rat means chuha. Rat eat grains. And snake eat rat. Then eagle eat snake. Now look it as in this way, eagle eat snake, snake eat rat, and rat eat grapes. This process is known as food chain. So, a food chain always begins with a plant because plants make their own food. Do you know this? Plants always make their own food. We humans make food outside our body. But the plant make their food inside their body. So all animals depend on plant directly or indirectly for their food. So all the animals depend on plants either directly comment section and mention your doubt. And if you like our videos of Delhi Public School Banu Chhapar Bettiya, then please like it, share it, subscribe it, and don't forget to press the bell icon.